up YouTube? I'm Spang Tangler and welcome to my shop. Today we're going to be installing a Mantic clutch on my GT350R. I've got it pulled apart right now. We're just assembling it. Come along, let me show you how to do this. I'm going to start by putting all these freaking bolts in the back. They're freaking bolts. Anytime you're doing a new clutch, it's always a good idea to put a new slave cylinder in. Take care of opening this thing. All right, there we go.
About to put in here?
Man,
this thing's gonna be fast or what?
It sure is.
Going up.
Let's take off the exhaust. Before you can take off the exhaust, you've got to unhook the O2 sensors. And don't unhook the O2 sensors before you've unplugged the battery.
Just for good measure, I like to check out if my hands are working. Woo! This drive shaft's gonna have to come out of here if we're gonna get anywhere. Alright, so I'm going to start taking off all these bolts and get the clutch off, and then we'll take the flywheel off. And we're looking at like 38 pounds of weight reduction. So, because that's rotating mass, this is going to be awesome. Nice twin disc clutch, still in good shape, not slipping, no problems. Just want to get a little bit less rotating mass. That's all your weight right there. This thing is one fat bastard, I'll tell you what. Completely different freaking deal here. Alright, I just like to line up where that hole's supposed to go. Alright, so obviously, this is a heck of a lot lighter, and make sure you get your bolts in for your clutch before you put the flywheel onto the crank. Otherwise, you'll be pulling it back off to do it again. All right. This thing will only go the one way. Right there.
Are these coffee filters or are these cats?
They're for noise. Little bit of O'Reilly's Finest. Don't want any dust, debris, finger oils, old people smell on this clutch. All right, so this will be the first plate we put on, and on the Mantic clutch, you'll notice that this side is pretty much flat, this black piece here, but this piece is sticking out. You want the sticking out part forward. That's just gonna slide up. I find it's easiest to take your clutch plates, your pressure plates, just with one piece. You don't have to get your fingers on any of it, which is kind of impossible. Slide that up in there. And then you can put your front plate on.
Got it.
Before you put your new FR3V7A508AA slave cylinder in, it's always a good idea to break
bleed this, get a little fluid in it. You get this up in the transmission and it's got air bubbles in it, good night. So I just like to stuff it in the kind of brake fluid you're using and just kind of massage it nice and slow until you stop seeing the bubbles come out.
I bet I can do it.
Before I put these exhaust pipes on, I'm gonna use a little Freel.
Everything tastes better with some Freel.
For those of you at home, that's Freel.
That's how we say it here in Utah.
You might call it Freel, but I call it Freel. It's all finished up. We're ready to fire it up, take it around for a test drive, see what we get out of it. Pretty excited.
Shout out to Jeff at Mantic Clutches. I'm loving my new clutch. This thing is rappy.